things through. You have to know where you're going and why you're doing it.
Well, there's a certain amount of room for, you know, just inspiration, and that's how I write. I mean, I write from a sort of a bolt of inspiration, but then there's a craft to songwriting too, which is largely ignored. There's a, you know, it's one thing to have a good idea for a song. It's another thing to present it in a way that's going to be interesting to people.
Yeah, do you think that's lacking today in some of the songs that we hear today? There's no craftsmanship,
yeah,
there's no
songwriting,
pride?
Yeah, songwriting as an art and as a craft is basically dead. I don't think there's anything, with a few exceptions, there's not anything interesting going on right now.
So were you surprised at your success, that you took so much care in developing your songs and formulating your songs, and yet you're able to have the chart play that you do?
Yeah, I'm always surprised. I'm surprised by everything that happens, good or bad. Because, I mean, there's really no way of predicting what's going to happen in the music business. So whenever anything happens, it's usually a surprise.
Have you had to make any compromises? Have you had to sort of fight for what you've wanted to do? Or has the record company given you carte blanche?
Well, we've been pretty lucky. In the creative aspect, the record company has pretty much stayed out of it. We've basically been able to work with the producer we wanted to and work in pretty much in seclusion.
Yeah, which not a lot of people get to do.
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, because I hear stories of tampering or you know, sort of people's subtle suggestions of how to do a song.
Yeah.
You don't get any of that.
Not really. I guess we come off as sort of having an idea of what we want, so.
Yeah, there's been a lot of changes in the band as well. You've changed sort of personnel between the first album and the second album.
Yeah, periodically people tend to leave.
Is that good for the band? Is that good for you as sort of the singer-songwriter?
Well, I mean, it's a sort of a double-edged sword. I mean, I would never gratuitously change members just for the sake of doing it, but when new people come in, it's sort of like an injection of new blood, and that's always very invigorating. At the same time, when people leave a band, it's almost like a breakup of a family, because you're with these people all the time, you travel with them, and you see the people in your band more than you see anybody else, so there's really two sides to it.
It's almost like starting all over again.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah. Tell me about what your future plans are and what you're working on now.
Well, we're just finishing up this tour. We've been touring since May. We'll finish up sometime in October. And then we'll start thinking about our next record, which we'll probably start doing in February.
Yeah. Any ideas? Any ideas of what you want to look at in the next album?
It'll be slightly different than the first two. We're not under any pressure to make another record like the last one. And so we'll probably do something slightly more adventurous on this one, I think.
Yeah. Will you look for a new producer?
More than likely, yeah.
Yeah. When you talk about adventurous, are you want a different sound, or are you looking for a different edge to your songs, or?
Yeah, probably just explore different sounds and possibly different kinds of subject matter. I think the first two albums sort of completed a certain kind of statement. I think it would start to become redundant if we kept going over the same ground. At the same time, it will. I mean, I have a pretty much entrenched songwriting style, so it won't be wildly different, but it will be hopefully an expansion on what's already there.
All right. Well, Mo Berg, good luck with Pursuit of Happiness. Good luck with all your future endeavors, and thanks for joining us today.
Oh, my pleasure.
Thank you.